How are you?
Oh my goodness, all our wonderful friends are with us, Dino.
It's been a great day. I'll tell you, God has been blessing us all this whole day. You know, we're getting ready for our trip tomorrow to Linda, California. We can't wait to see some of you guys there.
Amen.
And actually, we were a little rushed before coming on here because Cheryl cut my hair tonight.
And it's,
don't complain about it. I hope you like it. If you don't like it, don't say anything. Okay. But Cheryl, you know, years ago, she's a beautician. Before I married her, and she did very well. And she's been doing my hair ever since. We've saved a lot of money, that's for sure. And then just about an hour ago, she started cutting my hair. She cut it shorter, and I feel good in it. It's great. And how are you? This is not about me, it's about you. I hope you're doing well today. I hope you have a wonderful day. I really do. I just feel like I played Exodus at the very beginning of this program. Well, it's a program. It's actually a time just with you in your living room, in our living room. And it's always fun to share with you and tell you how good God is and how he's about to bless you abundantly in a marvelous way. Do you believe that, Cheryl?
Yes, I do.
I gotta talk louder because people say they can't hear me, especially when I'm playing.
And that I'm too loud.
Well, then you better stand way back, Cheryl.
Well, I'll try.
Either that or put some clothes on and come here and sit next to me.
Well, I have clothes on, but...
I know you got clothes on. But you know what I mean.
Yeah,
but
I'm not dressed up.
But we're packing, getting ready for tomorrow to have a glorious time in California.
Yes, we are.
We're believing for 3 nights. We're going to be at the Seventh-day Adventist, actually the university there. Loma Linda University, and it's going to be 3 nights of camp meeting, and it's been a pleasure to be invited to this. We've never done this before, but looking forward to it. A lot of great people in that Seventh-day Adventist Church, that's for
Amen.
You, for sure. Dan and Yvonne, of course, you know,
yes.
they're the ones that...
The Sheltons, all of
the
them.
The Sheltons, they're the ones that own that television station that
yes.
we play, and we're talking about doing a weekly show on that particular network, which is fun.
That would be awesome, wouldn't it?
I tell you, Cheryl, isn't it great? God is opening such amazing doors this year.
Yes, he is.
We've been expecting an amazing year, mm-hmm. and we're expecting it for you, too.
Amen.
And I say that because we're not going to be together too long as far as on this Facebook, because I have a little surprise for you.
Yes.
And we're going to take you to Florida, and no one has seen this yet, has not been on national television around the world. We've reserved it just for you. You're the first people to watch the hour special that we did as a little bit of a, would you say promo, Cheryl, about
yes.
the show we're going to do there on a weekly basis?
Absolutely.
We're going to be on CTN, Christian Television Network. You have to look it up now. Some of you will say, well, we don't get it, but I mean, you've got to really check it out because in the 800s or 900 channel, however you, wherever that is, but look for Christian Television Network.
CTN.
And we did an hour special. I played, we talked, and we introduced the concept of our hymn and worship half hour regular show every week. Can you believe that? We're going to be on every week. And we start filming in March. And the studio is in Largo, Florida. But we have that hour special that we did talking about this, and I'm playing, Cheryl and I are talking, Cheryl is reading from our hymnal, and I'm telling you, it was a glorious time.
It was wonderful. We had the best
time. The power of God was so fantastic, even that 1 hour. So you're going to watch that. So call your friends, share this with a lot of your friends that you know that they'll be able to watch this. They'll be the very first, the premiere, to watch this evening before it even starts playing. Actually, it starts, is it next week? I believe, I think it's next week. We'll have to give you the dates on that. You can watch it actually on television. But tonight, you can watch it on Facebook.
Isn't that
exciting?
So when
I end with you here, we're going to go right to that. So we're going to cut this short because it's an hour special. And I don't want to keep you up too late because I know some of you, not only grandmas, but some guys have to work and get to bed early.
Yes.
So
yes.
We're going to believe that. When it plays throughout the United States and the world, they're saying it goes everywhere. Can you believe we're going to do it? It all started right here on Facebook, Cheryl.
Yes.
This is where we started our hymn revival, our
yes,
hymn restoration.
Yes, it is. Isn't it
and
so
And look how it's, great. It's
awesome.
Going around the world now. Around the world.
You know what I love is when people come on and they greet each other because they're on every week with us.
Yes.
And then the most wonderful time we ever have is in the presence of the Lord.
Always.
And we all join together in His presence, and the Holy Spirit just moves in our lives through each one of us, and greeting the other makes it so awesome. Love that, Dino.
Present our requests, whatever we're asking in your name.
Yes.
You will deliver.
Thank you, Jesus.
If we will ask by faith to receive.
And we do that.
So we thank you for those that will be praying for each other. I know even when this is over, mm-hmm. we have those that just pray on Facebook. It's just an amazing ministry that
Amen.
You've given to all of us.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's not just Cheryl and I, but it's
no.
every person that faithfully watches this program and shares the glory of God. We are surely in the presence of the Lord tonight.
Thank you.
Lord, I pray for that person right now that is going through some difficult times. We do this every week because mm-hmm. there's always someone out there that's had maybe a difficult week, or perhaps there's been a separation, or there's been a some kind of urgency or a hospital a visit that didn't turn out very well. But I pray tonight that it
yes.
all will just smooth over by the presence of our Heavenly Father. Lord, I pray for that young man right now that's watching. I pray that you'll deliver that which he's needing mm-hmm. to supply food, supply clothing for his family.
Yes, Lord.
I pray that he will miraculously receive that which he needs to take care of that family that he has.
Amen.
I don't know, Lord, I just laid that on my heart. There's someone that's really struggling financially. Well, I pray for them, Father, whoever else it may be. We receive your blessings and your gifts.
Amen.
That you give us every day. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. And once again, we are here in a very special way. Just that sometimes there are times I don't even want to talk, and I just want to look at you and just pray in my heart for you. Because I know there's some needy people out there.
Right.
And Cheryl, you know every week, we hear requests, right?
Yes, we do. We hear requests for healing
yes.
and for lost
yes.
and dying loved ones without Jesus. And we hear that there are those that truly have need. And I want to share something that our sweet sister-in-law shared on Sunday morning.
What is that, sir?
Someone out here, and I don't know who you are, but you packed up, because we have need at our church of food for those who are going hungry, you packed a box of good things for others and actually mailed them to our church. And there are people who are having meals tonight that would not have had food. I just thank you. I don't know who you are, but thank you so much.
To bless someone, right?
To bless others, yes.
Jesus shine.
in our community or
make us a blessing.
In our state,
yeah. Yeah.
Then we are going to see needs met.
Yeah. That's what I love about our church. And there are many churches like this. I know. By the way, have you heard about that church? Where was it? Tulsa or somewhere in Oklahoma? Where, sir, I don't know if you heard this, but the church covered all medical bills of those that attended.
Oh my goodness.
The church, or members of the church. Now, think about that.
Yes.
What a wonderful thing. It was, I don't know how many millions of dollars they put out there to cover the cost of medical bills. A lot of people don't have insurance.
How outstanding is that?
Isn't that wonderful?
It is.
I love that. I thought it was such a wonderful thing that took place.
Yes.
But our church does the same thing, and I'm sure yours does. And if it doesn't, it needs to, because I'll tell you what.
Right.
When you give, that opens the door for major blessing in your life.
That's right.
Whether it's financial or whether it's just a can of food or whatever you bring to church.
The Lord knows.
For the hurting folk that don't have food, that don't have finances.
Right.
I'll tell you what, it returns to you. And we don't give just to receive. But you know what I'm talking about.
But it's a blessing.
But it's all God.
It's a blessing from the Lord that if we give, we shall receive. If we give with a heart of love.
Yes.
And giving, that we will receive.
Every time. We've
pressed down, shaken together, and running over.
Yes.
Shall men give into your bosom? A fast one, Mr. Dino.
Don't we do this running? Is that how it goes?
Yes.
So it's
running over, my cup is full and running over.
Since the Lord
saved me, I am happy as a king. My cup is full and running over.
You remember that one from Sunday school.
And every one of our cups can be full and running over.
That's right.
If we pour it out to someone else, as it comes in,
yes.
We give it out.
Yes.
Open hands.
Oh,
then
wow.
The Lord can pour through us.
Lord, I receive. How's
thank
that?
You, Jesus.
Reach out like
yes,
this and say, Lord,
amen.
I receive into my life.
I receive
into the life
it, and I want
my parents, my children, my grandchildren.
Amen.
I know you love your grandchildren.
So amen.
We love ours, too. It's
yes,
so precious.
We do.
This is amazing. Well, now I hope you're going to contact your friends. Because in a few minutes, I'm going to be putting on Facebook the one-hour special that we did in Largo, Florida. At Christian Television Network, CTN.
Uh-huh.
Okay? Now, of course, we've been on PTL, we're right now on CTN and PTL. And you know, it just goes on and on. The Lord is, you know, when you really think about it, Cheryl, God has placed some amazing, you know, because I believe when you're faithful to the Lord, when you follow His word, and when you walk not in the flesh but in the Spirit, God will open doors that you can't imagine for you. I know He
will.
That's
right.
He's about to open some great doors for you guys.
Amen.
So just receive it. Say, thank you, Lord. Lord, just sing this. Lord, I receive. Well, you know, I just heard today, and I have to share with Cheryl, that one of our precious friends here in Branson passed away this past Saturday. And, you know, this whole day I was thinking how quickly this life goes.
It does.
I remember, as a matter of fact, he owned Gilberti's, a restaurant here in Branson called Gilberti's.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of
Gilberti's.
People go there, best Italian food in town.
Yeah.
And we were right there when he opened the first day, he and Susie.
Yes.
We were there for the very first day that they opened in Hollister. And we shared happy times and wonderful times.
Oh,
we sit around
we
with
did.
The lasagna and all the things that they cook, and the pizzas were amazing. But Wayne loved God. He really
did. Yes,
he did. And I just found that out today, that last Saturday, he passed away. But you know what? We got to be ready. And I believe he was ready.
Yes.
He loved the Lord with all his heart. But we must prepare to be
Amen.
Ready to to know that we know that we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that we will be in the presence of God.
Yes.
God Almighty.
Praise you.
Gathering around the throne of God, rejoicing. Yes. Can you imagine? Just think about what that's going to be like.
Eternity.
Forever, ever, ever.
Yes, for eternity.
Yeah, we've been studying Revelation lately, and we're seeing what exactly what things are already in place.
Yes.
Now, I'm not a theology professor or anything, but when I read the Word, I mean, it's clear as can be.
Yes.
I mean, it's right there in the Word. Remember, years ago, Revelation wasn't taught that much. I remember as a little kid, you know, our church never preached on Revelation or taught Revelation. But the closer we get to the rapture, the closer we get to the end of our time on this earth, and it's getting close.
Mm-hmm.
No doubt about it. I know there's all kinds of elections going on, what have you. That's okay. That'll keep going. But God's unfailing love will carry us through to the very end.
Amen.
To the very end.
And
it's, you know, we must rejoice to know that someday we're going to see Him. No fear, no anxiety.
No doubt.
And no doubt. And when you have Jesus Christ in your life, there won't be any fear or anxiety.
No, there won't.
You're going to be so happy to receive Him. And just take that deep, that last breath and say, thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And then there we rest in the presence of God.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Not that you're going to die or anything. I'm just, you know.
It's just
something that we can really rejoice in.
It's so pleasing to your heart and your spirit to know that to be absent from the body is,
and as we talk, speak about that,
to be at rest and present with the Lord.
Memories. Talking. I'd rather play the piano than talk. A lot of you probably say the same thing too. But I just like to be able to just relax with you and just share things that are happening in our lives and what's going on. But before we end this Facebook session and we go into that 1 hour special, now in between, give me some time because I'm going to send it to you. All right? I'm going to send it to all our Facebook followers. It's going to be on my Dino fan page. You'll be able to watch the 1 hour special we did in Largo, Florida, which introduces everyone around the world that we're going to be doing hymns and worship. Half hour show every week on CTN.
Amen.
You got to get that network. If you don't, find out where you can get it for sure. And be with us every week on that. Now, are we going to stop Facebook? I don't think so. Once in a while, yeah, absolutely. But you know what our schedule is, and it's been very busy lately. A lot of folks have been saying, Lino, you're coming back to Facebook. Yes, here we are. And we will ever, ever not disconnect our relationship because we love you. And we've kind of grown up together. Let's put it that way. We've come a long way, baby, like you say.
Yes, we have. And the Lord
That's
has...
That's what I do, baby. This is what we do. We just kind of play and sing and worship. And hopefully someday we'll come to your town and do our hymn revival. We're going to be in Dallas, we're going to be in Houston, we're going to be in a lot of places, so you have to check our schedule, and Miss Brenda will keep you posted. Trust me, she's very efficient, and she will keep you in touch.
Yes,
Brenda
she
Hayes.
Will. Dino, Rhonda Barrett wrote, my pastor did a sermon last Sunday entitled, What's to Come? And she said, it was powerful.
Ooh.
If you aren't excited about heaven, just read your Bible.
That's all.
And God will reveal
yes.
to you.
Yes.
And that's the truth.
And all the aches and pains are going to go away.
Oh, yes.
No more arthritis, no more cancer, no more kidney problems, no more no more any of that.
No.
That the devil has placed on this earth.
That's
right. The truth. But when we get to heaven, it's going to be just glorious.
Yes, it will.
You talk about glorious. It will be amazing. Walking the streets of gold. You talk about People sometimes complain about my ring. I mean, I've been wearing this for over 50 some odd years, you know. And some still say, well, it's too gaudy, what have you. But you know what? Get used to it, because we'll get to heaven. Oh. If you get to heaven, you talk about, it's not going to be gaudy. It's going to be absolutely elegant and gorgeous. Well, the Bible, Revelation tells us about that. Streets of gold and the gates
Pearl.
But of one pearl.
One pearl.
Can you imagine what that looks like? A lot of you women wear these little pearls, but imagine that as a huge gate.
Stones all over the place.
Oh, it's going to be amazing.
All kinds and gorgeous and glorious and beautiful.
Well, there was a time when, you know, in our churches, especially the Pentecostal church, where jewelry and all that was not acceptable. And not necessarily when some wears jewelry like myself, or it doesn't mean that you're rolling in the dough, you know, that you're a millionaire. You know, you have to understand that what the story is behind these, the jewelry that have been given to us, and the things that God has given us. Well, he wants to give the same to you.
Oh, yes, he
and
does.
And you receive it. You receive it graciously.
But if you don't receive it, you won't be worried with it, because it won't come.
Jewelry, and that's fine.
You know,
I can respect that too.
Sure.
But I happen to be, you know, when I was born with wearing tails.
And a bow tie.
Listen, I was wearing tails and really dressing up church concerts when that wasn't even in years ago. Mm-hmm. And I kind of stood out like a sore thumb. When I was on, actually, Catherine Kuhlman's program, you remember years ago, on Catherine Kuhlman, she had this huge chandelier and the Steinway piano, and she loved beautiful things. And so that image kind of created for me, and I fell right into it, and it's fine. It's not my main thing. I mean, I don't, you know, actually, the good thing about wearing this ring, in case some of you are wondering, is when people recognize me, sometimes they recognize the ring before they recognize me. I saw that ring on television, you know. But if I go to church where it's not accepted, well, we'll take it off. You know, we'll honor and respect.
Yes.
What that denomination
we
is.
Do.
You know,
yes,
we don't live for all the material things, although they're nice to have. And
they're a sweet addition.
But we
when they're gifted to you.
Yeah, and sure, when we wear those earrings and the jewelry, you look great.
Well,
you
thank you, sir.
You wear it so beautifully.
Thank you.
But the main thing is that we are living for Christ.
Yes.
That's what it's all about. Okay, I got to stop talking, because you guys, I want you to go to bed before you see this hour special. So I'm going to sign off, give about 5 minutes, and I will send it through Dino fan page. Be sure to watch and comment and let me know what you think of that hour special. Now, I'm sitting at the piano, beautiful piano, beautiful set. Cheryl's right next to me, and then we have Bob and Jane.
Yes, from CTN, the owners,
CTN.
The originators, I believe.
Yeah, Bob, precious man. You'll see he's very soft-spoken, but how powerful he is in his ministry. He even helped so many people to get on television.
Yes,
he owned the studio or this network for years and years and years. And
yes.
And built it debt-free. Isn't that wonderful?
That is
and
amazing.
And spreading the gospel around the world. So what you're going to watch in just a few minutes, it's not going to go around the world. It's going to go into just your world, because we're playing this especially for you to watch. And then we'll give you a schedule when it plays on TV and have your friends watch that. But they can also watch it on Facebook right now. Okay? Is there anything else, Cheryl, you want to share?
I just want to tell you all that God is real. Our God is real. He's real in our soul.
You're always putting a song in my heart when you talk like that.
Yes.